Good morning, Chilin. Chilin, today we will start with our new chapter, chapter number 2, Chemical Changes and Reactions. Chilin, chemical change. Chilin, in the lower standard, you already learned about physical and chemical changes. What do you mean by physical and chemical change? A physical changes are changes in which no new substances are formed. And what do you mean by chemical change in which new substances are formed? So children, in this chapter, we learn about chemical changes and reactions. Why reactions? Because children, the chemical changes leads to formation of new compounds. The reactions between the two compounds to form a new product, new compound. Chemical change is a permanent change in which the chemical composition of the substance is changed and one or more new substance with different chemical compositions and different properties are formed. The change is not easily reversible. A chemical change always involves a chemical reaction. What do you mean by chemical reaction? Chemical reaction is a process of breaking of chemical bonds of the reacting substance and making new bonds to form new substance or product. A chemical bond is a force of attraction which holds the atoms together to form molecule or compound. So children, the chemical change or reaction occurs when particles collide. Collisions occurs when reactants are come closer to each other. So children, here we required some conditions for formations of new compound, formations of chemical change or formation of chemical reactions. What is the first one? First one is close contact. In some cases, a chemical reaction occurs when two substances are mixed in their solid state. Children, here we are having example of iodine and phosphorus react explosively when brought into close contact. Solution. In some cases, chemical reactions occurs when substances are mixed in either molten or aqueous state. Here we are having example of sodium chloride and silver nitrate. They are only react when they are in a solution form. Heat. Some chemical reactions require heat. We have to supply energy. Light. Some chemical reactions takes place only by the actions of light. They are called photochemical reactions or photolysis. Molecules of the reactant absorb light energy to get activated and then react rapidly. Previous one, we are applying energy in the form of heat. Here we are applying energy in the form of light. Now children, the next one is we are having example of silver nitrate. When it exposed to the sunlight, it just decomposed and gave gray color silver. Next one is electricity. Here we are applying energy in terms of electricity, which is called electrolysis or electrolytic decomposition. Children, a simple one, electrolysis, we are having electrolysis of water. As we pass an electricity, the water molecules are decomposed into hydrogen and oxygen gas. Pressure. Some chemical reactions takes place only when involved the substances are subjected to high pressure. Children, here we are having example a famous Haber's process of formation of ammonia gas. Nitrogen and hydrogen gas is mixed at above 200 atm atmospheric pressure and form ammonia. Catalyst. Children, what do you mean by catalyst? Chemical reactions need catalyst to accelerate or decelerate the rate at which they occur. Either they increase or decrease the rate of reactions. So catalysts are the substances which are not taking part in the reaction, but they presence or they increase decrease rate of reaction. The catalyst themselves do not take part in the reaction, so remain unchanged. Certain chemical reaction process by absorption of sound energy also. Now children, here we are having example of catalyst. Children, we are having potassium chlorate in presence of manganese dioxide. It decomposes into potassium chloride and oxygen gas. Now children, we are having two type of catalysts, positive and negative. What do you mean by positive catalyst when the rate of reaction is increased in presence of catalyst? When catalyst accelerated a reaction, it is known as positive catalyst. Hydrogen peroxide in presence of manganese dioxide converted into water plus O2. Enzymes are also example of positive catalyst. During digestion, the food is completely digested into simpler one by actions of enzyme. Otherwise, we required a month, days to digest our food. Children, negative catalyst. A catalyst which employ to retard a reaction. What it means? They decrease the rate of reaction. Children, now what happened? We are having various type of chemical reaction. Some reactions are occurs so fastly, we have to control that rate of reaction. So intentionally, we just reduce the rate of reaction. There we are using negative catalyst. The rate of oxidation of chloroform decrease in presence of alcohol. So children, these are the conditions which are required to perform the chemical reaction. Heat, electricity, pressure, energy, catalyst, either in a close contact in a solution form, either in a solid form. Now children, there are some characteristics of chemical reactions. How can we know that chemical reactions are occurs? So children, here we are having some observations. We are having something which tell us, yes, something is happening, some new things are formed. What are these observations? First one, evolution of gas. Children, some reactions are occurs with evolution of gases. Sometime a color gases are also formed. Brown, yellow. Children, in many chemical reaction, the one product is gas. Here we are having a very famous explanation or very famous example of zinc metal when react with sulfuric acid. Children, whenever any metal react with sulfuric acid, they release hydrogen gas. Here clearly you can see that the release of hydrogen gas is shows by upward arrow. This upward direction arrow shows evolution of gas. Children, this hydrogen gas is released with a specific sound. A pop sound is produced. A pop sound is produced. Effervences. Sometimes the formation of gas bubbles are there, which is present in liquid during reaction is called effervences. Best example, ENO. When you add ENO, which contains sodium bicarbonate, converted into sodium carbonate and release lots of carbon dioxide gas. Second observation, change of color. Array, whatever the solution we are having, it's having a different color. And whatever the product we are getting, it is also having a different color. So children, by changing color, we are getting a new observation, indication of some chemical reactions are occur. Certain chemical reactions are characterized by change in the color. Children, here we are having example of Fe plus CuSO4. The basic color of CuSO4 is blue. When we add some Fe iron crystals, iron nails, the color change into green due to formation of iron sulfate, ferrous sulfate, formation of precipitates. Children, what do you mean by precipitate? Children, some reactions are involved with production or produce insoluble substance which settle down at bottom. Here we are having example of AgNO3 plus NaCl. When silver nitrate react with sodium chloride, they produce a silver chloride. White precipitations are formed, which are insoluble and settle down at the bottom. And until the last one is change of state. In many chemical reaction, the change of the state is observed. The reaction might start with a gaseous or liquid reactant and we are getting a solid product, vice versa. Children, here we are having a beautiful example of carbon, which is solid state. React with the sulfur, both solid on on heating together they produce carbon disulfide, which is liquid. Children, here clearly you can see that we are having exercise 2A. Children, you have to write down this all 7 question answers in your notebook. This is your today's homework. Bye children, have a nice day.